So this is Holland America's ship, the Westerdam. We're in stateroom 8047.
Whenever you first come in, over to the left are three closets. There's actually a good amount of space in the closets. Enough space at the bottom to put medium to large suitcases. Open that one, Raymond. So tons of space, hangers provided, space at the bottom for those suitcases and for shoes. Also a safe. The side of the bathroom is a full-length mirror. Bathroom is actually pretty large for a cruise ship stateroom. Place to hang towels. Typical toilet for a cruise ship. A place for two people to get ready, which is really nice. A lot of counter space there for toiletries, makeup, etc. Something pretty interesting is that it does have a tub. It has a shower, but there's also a separate shower. On the wall, it has the dispenser for the bath gel, the conditioner, and the shampoo. So there's one in the small shower, and there's another one over here with the tub and the shower. There's a vanity area and a mirror for putting on makeup. There's a nice couch and a coffee table. The TV is really, really big. I haven't seen one this big in a cruise stateroom. The king size bed. It has nightstands on each side, lights on each side. Over here is like a mini bar area and a desk. Comes with a fridge down here that's already stocked. I'm not for sure if that's included. I'll have to check. I'm pretty sure it's separate. This stateroom category also comes with some binoculars, so some Bushnell binoculars we can use while on the Alaska voyage. It has a balcony. So we are on the 8th deck. Here's the port of Vancouver. So we're sailing out of Vancouver, British Columbia. It's a large balcony. It has two lounge chairs, it has a table. Pretty large balcony.
connected to the Pacific Ocean, and it is salt water, so it does not freeze over during the winter. On the other side of the channel over there is Douglas Island. It's just outside the tram, there are two buildings. The first one off to the right is the Juneau Raptor Center. They have a live bald eagle there by the name of Lady Baltimore. She's been in captivity for over 10 years now.
Nailed it. And sorry about that background.
Really cold.
Exactly. In the quest this year, it was negative 50 to negative 60 the first six nights of the race, with daytime highs of negative 45. And then on day seven, it warmed up to 30 above zero.
What are you doing?
Woody! What are you doing down there? Woody! And Woody here is going to be a father any day now. I have a litter due this weekend, actually. So.
Thinking on what I'm doing, but typically I'm really going to go out with less than 12. And all my adult race dogs are going to average about 35 miles a day of training. Here in the summer, this trail's 2 miles long. We're going to go 2 to 3 times, so 4 to 6 miles, about 4 to 5 days a week. Only like it is today, about 40% of the time. Thank you.
Sure is.